on May 5th, I put my vehicle on a ship, a ferry in Bellingham, Washington, and sailed 1,000 miles up to Skagway, Alaska. And that is the entire Inland Passage. This is the vehicle that I took on the ferry with me. And this is my boarding pass, the very much awaited boarding pass. And this is Bellingham, Washington, and that is the Columbia. And it's backed into the ramp so people can drive onto it. It fits about 120 vehicles.
The ATV?
Yeah, the ATV.
Okay.
So the ship has 7 decks, and the bottom 2 are for vehicles only, and off limits while underway. You can see those orange things are tie downs for vehicles if the seas get rough. That's the Lexus GX 470 that I'm using right now in Alaska. So this guy I met, he did a build on his van. He's gonna be living in it. He put a wood stove in his passenger seat.
You know what I'm saying? Look at this right here.
You're smart.
Yeah. Weighs 100 pounds.
What does?
That stove. It's the real deal.
The Great 1700, they came all the way from tinywoodstove.com.
Wow.
In Idaho. They make one smaller.
I know, I've seen them in
you gotta feed it through the night every hour.
Ah, yes.
This one.
Yeah. You put that insulation in? Wow.
That's a closed cell phone.
Wow.
Yeah, I just got brand new wool blankets I gotta put over it. Yeah.
this water or food?
No food, but beer? I got 7 of these, and that's what my bed supports on.
Oh, wow. That sounds like a good idea.
Yeah, because it's all storage.
Sure.
Yeah. I can take the bed out anytime, grab a barrel.
Nice.
But, I got to put my cargo carrier on the outside.
You have a chainsaw or anything?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Got a chainsaw. Yeah. I even brought a sawzall to cut dead branches.
What are you going about, man?
So we're going to go walk into the ship and go upstairs. We'll go on a little bit of a tour, not too big of one. This ship was built in 1975. Solid is it's amazingly strong. This is the purser's office, and this reminded me of a Stephen King movie. The top deck, the 7th level, and this is where I will be staying for the next 4 days. And as you see, this is Bellingham, Washington, and people are still getting their vehicles loaded on and heading upstairs, and this is going to be a very busy place in the next hour or two.
This is home for the next 4 days.
Is powered by 2 9-cylinder diesel engines that burn heavy fuel oil, and together they put out 15,000 horsepower. So the ship cruises at 17 knots, and that is 24 hours a day. Obviously, we make some stops along the way. I think we make we stop in 7 towns in 4 days, and usually just for an hour. And but this ship then turns around and comes all the way back, and that's what it does all summer. 1,000 miles north, 1,000 miles south. Good weather, bad weather. So this is the view to the front. That is Baranoff Island. We're headed to Sitka through a very roundabout, narrow channel, and I'll be showing you that in a minute or two.
Woo! It is cold.
So the ship travels 24 hours a day, and sometimes at night we'll go through these very narrow places, and the crew mans these spotlights, and it's actually quite a sight to get up and watch. And if you fell overboard, hopefully they'd be tossing you one of these. But I don't think you'd live long enough to get pulled back on shore. The water's in the low 40s, like 43 degrees. So we spent the night for 2 hours anyway in Sitka, and now it is early the next morning, and we're heading back into the Sitka Narrows, and it's quite an interesting passage. As you can see, the shoreline in some places at low tide, you could throw a rock and hit the shore, and this is almost a 500-foot ship. This is no other cruise ships go through here, only the ferry. There are times that we actually had to pull over and wait for a tugboat or some other boat to get through the passage before we could proceed. And that's coming up here in a bit. It's kind of an interesting maneuver because of the tides.
Thank you. I think they're waiting. Exactly. Yes.
Yeah. How cool is that?
That was what I thought too.
I remember seeing a mountain on my first trip to Sitka, coming through here in the daytime. That was just like Mount Everest. It was so tall and pointy.
That was Steve, turned out to be a good friend. He's commenting on top of these containers, shipping containers, are parked big rigs, and it kind of gives you a scale to focus in on that. These are ocean-going tugs and barges, and they are used everywhere. It's the only way to move building materials and all sorts of stuff. Almost all of the towns, including Sitka and Juneau, the capital of Alaska, have no roads. The only way to get there is by either boat or by airplane. It's interesting how they trim the mountains with the same paint that they use on the boat. And it looks like they did it on purpose. So it is day 3, and we are coming into the capital of Alaska, which is Juneau. Juneau is landlocked, so there's no way in or out. There's no roads in or out. So it's either by water taxi or bush plane. And Juneau is also home to the Mendenhall Glacier. Unfortunately, there wasn't enough time to go explore it. It's too far out of town, so I contented myself with staying on the boat while we stopped and typed out some letters. These are some of the characters you get to know very quickly on board a ship. For one thing, we're all there for pretty much the same reason, and to enjoy Alaska. Some of the people, though, are actually going to their jobs for the summertime. Guides, these guys are all guides. Some people work in canneries, and then these guys are just tourists. And so this guy, Steve, what a neat guy. And this guy is a professional mechanical bull rider. I got a dead on the road.
Swinging ahead to Delta.
Unfortunately, this is the fourth and last day of one of the neatest things I've ever done in my life. I highly recommend it. It's not hard to do. You buy your tickets online and load your car and drive up. But in the meantime, we're going to pass this lighthouse. This was built in 1903. It's called Eldridge Rock Lighthouse. And it is built of Sitka spruce. It's an octagon. Still operates. And quite a lot of history. It is the oldest working lighthouse in Alaska. So there it goes. And behind it are the Chilkats. The Chilkat Mountains. And as you can see, as we get into Skagway, we've done about 1,000 miles, and the mountains continue to get higher and higher. And when it got light in Skagway, I was just stunned by the steepness of the mountains all around, and the narrowness and depth of the fjord, waterfalls and rivers coming down. But I've got to end this video because it's already gone way too long. So this is downtown Skagway.
He lays his breath.